Hey guys, you're about to watch a video that is so hard to make. Let's talk about all the reasons you shouldn't move to Washington. Hey guys, Sarah Carman here, your not so secret agent. And as a girl who has spent almost her entire life in the Pacific Northwest, this video is super hard to make because I think that both Oregon and Washington are amazing places to live. So much so that I currently live in Washington. I love it here. So it's really hard to think of the fact that this state might not be a good fit for everyone, but it's true. And so I want to talk about all the reasons you might not want to move to Washington State, and most specifically the Vancouver area. So dive in with me, get your popcorn and watch a real estate agent talk about all the reasons you shouldn't move here. First things first, I'm so excited about the fact that Washington State does not have an income tax. I grew up in Oregon where there was one, so it's crazy to think that when I make money, the state's not gonna take anything. Feds still take theirs, but my state isn't taking anything additional. So my taxable income, like, I get to keep more of my money. Like, that's so nice. But Vancouver does have a sales tax, and that is currently sitting at 8.4%. 8.4% for sales tax. Now, it's actually a little bit considered on the high side out here to be at 8.4. Yeah, little painful when you buy your car and you have to pay that much in taxes. It hurts, it stings a little bit, especially when you're from Oregon where you're not used to that. So if that percentage of sales tax is a bother for you, you might want to rethink the idea of moving to Vancouver. Well, the weather here, it can be a little bit of a problematic thing for those who aren't used to it. So yes, it's true. We do see rain here often in Washington. Now, I want to make it clear, it's not all day, every day, and actually it's average rainfall for the United States. The difference is that we see it in a drizzle throughout the winter time. So our summers are still warm, slightly humid, not terrible, not like the South, but it is still a little bit more of a humid heat rather than a dry heat. And then the winter times are typically cold and rainy. Washington sees about an average of 42 inches of rain, but it's spread out over the fall, the winter, and the spring. So it's a little bit here and there and throughout the day. With 42 inches of rain and multiple rivers and creeks and different areas with water, we do actually see our fair share of flooding. Now, I'm not talking about the flood that wiped out a whole entire neighborhood in the Portland, Oregon area, not like that, that's rare. I'm also not talking about like flooding like we saw in the 90s where I was able to like walk up to the Columbia River because it had raised so high. Like, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about where we crest over the flood line, and we do see that quite often. Flood insurance is a thing out here, and for those of you who've never had to pay flood insurance, it's not always cheap. Now, that would be something that I would refer to you to talk to your flooding insurance person, and I've got an amazing girl for insurance. Come talk to me. But flood insurance, yeah, that's a whole added cost of buying a home out here if you are in a floodplain. So if this isn't deterring you, just make sure that you talk to your agent about floodplains and what does it flood like. And when we say it floods, what does that mean? Is it like 3 feet of water in the house? Is it an inch of water in the house? Is it water that's lapping up on the front step and it never enters the house? But yeah, flooding, kind of a thing. So let's talk about Vancouver specifically. Did you know that it's actually considered a suburb of Portland, which is one state over? So if you're looking to move to a city that somebody can point out to on a map, Vancouver might not be the place you want to talk about because people are going to point to Portland. In fact, if you're looking for the airport, if you're looking for sports, if you're looking for anything, you're often going to be going either to Portland or Seattle. As big of a metropolitan area as Vancouver is, as big of a city as it is, it really doesn't have a lot of its own stuff. It shares with Portland as a suburb of Portland. And if that's a problem for you, well then Vancouver might not be the city you want to move to. It's just is what it is. if you're planning to move to Vancouver, because the housing prices are a little bit cheaper over here compared to Portland, and then commuting into Portland, we need to talk about some other issues you're gonna run into. Number one of those is traffic. There are two bridges between Oregon and Washington in the Portland-Vancouver area, the I-5 bridge and the 205 bridge. Now, the reality is that they get backed up on traffic, and if there's an accident at all on either of those bridges, you might as well just plan to sit in your car for a while. So traffic is kind of an issue there. On top of that, the second issue is you're gonna get semi-double taxed. Now, yes, I've been told that double tax is not allowed, you're not supposed to be taxed, da-da-da-da-da. But the reality is that Oregon has an income tax, Washington does not. Washington has a sales tax, Oregon does not. If you're working in Portland, you will have to pay the income tax that is there. And then you have to work with a tax person to try to figure out how to get whatever money back that you can get back. Now, that's all magic tax talk, and I would totally refer you to a tax person, but I do want to make you aware that if you are planning on living in Vancouver and working in Portland, you're gonna want to consider that income tax portion. All right, last but certainly not least, we need to talk about one very important thing. If you have any allergies to Sasquatch or any allergies to pollens or molds or that kind of stuff, you might want to reconsider Washington, especially if you're allergic to Sasquatch. This is Bigfoot's home, and he's out there somewhere. You may not believe in him, but he believes in you. So guys, listen, if allergies are an issue, you might want to take a look at the area. We do have a lot of plants and trees that bloom year round. I mean, Washington is the Evergreen State, and trust me, we are green. There's plenty of trees that are just amazing, and they're green. It's gorgeous. All right, I can't believe I just did that. I hope that you're not scared about Washington. It really is a beautiful state. Like I said, we're the Evergreen State. The trees here are green year round, and it is beautiful. And as much as it rains, that's what waters our yards and makes things amazing. All of those rivers that flood also provide us with some delicious fish. And Sasquatch, well, I mean, if you find him, you could get famous, right? So sneeze all you want. If you can get him on camera, you're golden. Thank you so much for joining me again today. I would love to know if you have a reason to not move to Washington, or if you actually have a reason that everybody should come to Washington, drop it in the comments. We will talk soon.